Hello, this is Leah, also known as Leah Iris Ellipses here on YouTube. And first of all, sorry that I've been away for so long. I moved into a house in March. My husband and I bought a house, and it's just been crazy busyness and projects and life and everything going on since that happened. So I haven't really, haven't gotten my stuff set up so that I can do makeup videos pretty close. One of the things that I was really looking forward to doing for the weekend was a little table reconstruction sort of project. I have a subscription to Do It Yourself magazine, so of course I'm always seeing the cool projects and the fun ideas and stuff, so I was just kind of inspired to do something like that for myself. So I got a little end table from Goodwill for $4 that I want to kind of turn into something that looks prettier. So let me show you the table. It's kind of, sort of retro looking. It's sturdy, but it's not in great looking condition, you know, like little spots there. These handles are real worn away. They're plastic anyways, they're just kind of like cheap. I mean, this is sort of that like ply board wood, you know, fake wood. As you can see, it's got those cool gold tips on the bottom. So yeah, it's just like the overall look of it is kind of retro, but I like the size and shape of it. You know, there's like some space, some storage in there. So I just thought, hey, for $4, this could be an experiment, and maybe the experiment would turn out well. I also kind of wanted to show the supplies I got for it and what I plan to do with it. I got this fabric to go over top of it, which would just be on this like tabletop part. That I plan to glue on top of it and maybe even lacquer over it, depending on what's needed, but it's just a black and cream fabric. I also got these supplies over here on the windowsill. I got two handles to replace the plastic ones. These are just kind of black handles. These were actually on sale. They're on clearance at Lowe's, so I only paid 78 cents each for both of them. I got three cans of spray paint. The first one here is primer, which is really important to have because it's gonna set the whole project. It's gonna set your wood, cover over the dark, especially since I'm gonna be using this light cream color. But then I'm also gonna use black. So I think what I've decided is to do the doors cream, and then everything else will be black, or maybe I'll do the legs cream also, something like that. Anyway, so that's the paint I got. Each of these was $4. Then I got this roller, which is actually like a wallpaper roller, but it'll also work on the fabric to like smooth out any air bubbles, so that's kind of good. I think this is like $5. From Joann Fabrics, I also got Mod Podge. This is like a decoupage glue, or it says it's a sealer glue and finish. So this will be used for the fabric. And then I also got this sponge to apply the glue. So all in all, let's see, that's about $2 for 4 and 4. So we're up to 14. The glue was 4, so that's 18. This was 5, that's 23. 23 and a quarter. The table was $4, so that's about 27 and a quarter. And then the fabric, I think, was $5. So did I just say we're up to 27 plus 5? So about $32, I guess, is what I'm spending on this project. So, yeah, I will touch base each step of the way and show you what I'm doing, and hopefully this will turn out into a cool project. All right, step one complete. I just washed off the whole thing just with water with dish soap in it. And then I also took off the handles off the doors, so you can see the little holes there where the screws had gone. So that is step one. Step two is going to be priming it. All right, step one complete. I have primed everything, the doors. I've primed all of that. I didn't get too detailed on the inside of that because I figured nobody's going to see that, and I wasn't sure how far my one can of spray paint would go. So anyway, got all that finished. It says it recommends a second coat, which I may want to do. I don't think you can see it super well, but there are some lines, some streaks. So sometimes with primer, it's not too important to have it completely white, you know, like opaque white, but I'd say especially for the doors, since I'm going to have a lighter color over them, I want those at least to be pretty solid. But since black's going over the rest of that, I might skip the second coat on that. But anyway, it says it takes an hour for it to be dry to the touch and I guess ready for the next step or the next paint process. So that actually works out perfect because I need to go feed my dog and play with him probably as well. So I'm going to go do that and then I'll be back later to start painting black. Alright, we now have the coat of black painted on the table, and of course I had to tag it since I'm using a spray paint here. Definitely want to comment that it is very messy, and don't underestimate the amount of spray paint dust that'll be flying around in the air. Definitely recommend a drop cloth and wearing a mask. Okay, I did some finishing touch-ups on the paint, and now I'm ready to get my fabric glued. I have it measured out about as exact as I can. It looks like some of the fabric does hang over the edge, though, but I think it'll probably be fine because I can just trim it, and we'll see how it goes. My plan for doing it is to start at the center, so I mean I'll put glue all over the top of it, but I'll start from the center and kind of smooth it out from there, and that way if the fabric stretches at all, hopefully it'll stretch outwards and it'll be easier and better to trim off the edges than have, you know, a blank spot here or there. But anyway, we'll see how it goes. I don't know if the fabric's gonna fray or what's gonna happen, so hopefully I'll have a good result. Okay, it is now about 2 days later and the project is finally finished. So here is the end result. Let me see if I can show you. It's a little bit bright in here, but basically this is what it looks like. I think you can see here there are a few little bubbles in the fabric, which I guess I'm okay with. I mean, I'm not too picky with this, seeing as it was my first undertaking of this sort. I now have the new handles on, so those of course look a whole lot better. There are a few little scuffs here and there just from putting it on that, you know, maybe I'll need to like get some touch-up paint or something, but overall I think it actually turned out fairly well. So, not a very hard project. If you are maybe a little more particular or a little more picky with it, you might want to take your time putting the fabric on and smoothing it out. There were a few parts where I used a little too much glue, so it was kind of like dribbling down the side, which you might not be able to see, but I can tell where it's like a little bit shiny on the side where it should be matte. But anyway, I think I actually didn't really need to get that roller. It didn't really do that much. Like just using an old gift card or credit card works pretty well for smoothing out the glue in the fabric. So I really didn't need the roller. So that would have saved me $5 and it would have been a $25 project. So overall, it was fun. I'll definitely get use out of this table. I like it. So I think all in all, it was a fun project and I'm glad I did it.